Since that same streamer's on a different platform now, I might as well watch something else. This is a bit odd. What's this on the main Twitch page? Ooh, this is a bit odd. Wow, those are not default characters for sure. Wow, they're really getting at it. Speedy, are you okay? I'm not watching much. I'm okay. Sweetie, is that something that you can not supposed to be watching? Mom! No, it's not what you think. Honey, you have to not watch that. You're being really naughty watching that. Mom!
It's a vlog. The streaming saga continues. As you may have heard from last week, a certain popular streamer has moved to a different platform. And this is a good opportunity for certain streamers to stream, you know, certain content, I should say, that happened this past 1 week. But that's people in a nutshell, I should say, despite streamers in general, even I'm a streamer somewhat myself. I'll mention some certain stuff that I've been not only streaming, but also watching certain streamers at the end of the video when it comes to streaming, despite being a YouTuber. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Wilkins, DT Films. It's a vlog. So for this vlog, even though that I do have some stuff to talk about for this vlog, but however, just yesterday, even though it's literally 10 years since yesterday I posted a certain vlog and regards on a certain thing that I've been wearing for quite some years now, because it's been literally 10 years since I've been wearing a military cap. For anyone that are really long subscribers back in the day, or for those that just watched me for quite some years, yes, I do like wearing my military cap, and there's like a certain reason behind that. But here's a little snippet from my 10 year anniversary video, just to see me rabbing, going to a tangent about it. Then I'll mention afterwards why I just like wearing it for quite some years now. When the Xbox 360 experience came out and introduced avatars, then later on the avatar marketplace was introduced and Stevie T kind of purchased a particular something. Then later on during a vlog, he mentioned about certain things that he has in real life and he wants to compare it to his avatar. But the problem is he doesn't have a military cap, so he actually purchased a military cap to be able to match. And then for some reason he kind of stick with it. So yeah, ever since I posted that vlog, I've just been really attached, not literally attached, I should say. You know, I just really like using my military cap, and there are quite some pros and cons despite wearing a cap. But I don't wear it all the time, you know. Well, when I'm streaming, you know, I don't usually wear my cap on my streams. Though I'm a messy as is. But I do get somewhat recognised in town, even without the patches sometimes, because everyone would know me. And when, like, say, oh, it's funny. For example, when my mum went to Granger Games one time, one of the staff members in Granger Games were like, are you the mum of so-and-so that has a military cap, if that makes sense. So it's good to be recognised in somewhat way, and despite, you know, patches or not, which I mentioned about patches in a bit, then sweat patches, all different topic. But yeah, even though that it does hide my messy hair, despite I do get it, because during the time, I didn't know when to really get into, like, getting my hair cut, because I've been doing it every 2 months now. But since then, I was like, you know, because my mum's eager to try and get my hair cut now and again, is another thing. And just lately, for the past some years now, I've been trying to, like, do it by myself and go to the hairdressers by myself, which I'm really getting used to now. The ladies that usually do it are really nice and doing it. And despite, you know, I know what I want now. It's like 4 on the sides and a bit long on top. But you can tell that I could do with cutting it, because I need, it's been like 2 months now. I need to get it, you know, somewhat nice before my birthday is another thing. Then it is, you know, just hiding from people is another thing, because, you know, it has that certain degree, what angle I should say, it could be like, yeah, I don't want to make eye contact is another thing. Which I tend to, not saying rarely do, but if I do stumble across someone, be like, no, I don't want to talk to you today. Because, you know, I have that tendency with people as it is, if you know what I mean. So I'm just going through my notes, despite I do have some, like, things to say. Then it's the patches in general. Because when I decide to, like, I might as well change my style up a bit. And because, you know, I've been wearing the same green hat for quite some years, and I do like certain, you know, video games as it is, and I thought this was a good concept, because I've been, well, I did have a Batman logo, despite clashing between a Batman logo with a Batman logo t-shirt, and that didn't do so well. So I ended up going for like a Zelda and Triforce thing, because this was during the time when Zelda Breath of the Wild was really coming out, and I really do enjoy that, despite playing some Zelda titles, and you can tell that it fits well in terms of like, even with the Halo patch, and because even though it's a smallish, widest patch, you know, because I've been wearing this certain brand, which is, Beachfield, I think it's called Beachfield. I should have grabbed the tag. But, you know, I usually use this certain brand, hashtag not sponsored, or but I've been going for the same brand that I usually buy on Amazon, because I buy the hat on Amazon, as well as the patches. Even a quite funny, which when me and Adrian went to MCM Manchester recently, and there were like a bunch of patches. And I quickly explained to Adrian, I don't know, because usually when these are not selling on Amazon, I have to use whatever patches that I have. And I only just refreshed this hat just recently, that it is with the method of... sweat patches, by sweat patches, because quite some years I've been getting like odd patches, and I realized just last year, because of the huge heat wave we had last year, I realized, oh, they're sweat marks. I didn't even know until like this year. Not this year, I mean last year, because you know we had a huge heat wave last year, and I've been recently discovered since the end of last year, I realised that I had to do somewhat extra protection when it comes to, you know, your blooming forehead and taking the sweat off your brow. Something from Bioshock. You know that quote from Bioshock in general. Take the sweat off your brow and all that. Anyways, but yeah, because I need to, like, have this extra cushiony. So I have to use, like, I should really refilter that, because I use like kitchen roll and I had to refilter that, and it makes it easier, which I need to, because I forgot to refilter that. But it's a good method, and I will grab the other hat despite the manyest of hats, because I do have spares. I don't have just the one hat. I do have spares, even though the before this refresh, the other one's now my spare, if that makes sense. But I still use that method anyway on the other hat, and despite having spares as it is. But it's a good method for those people that do kind of wear hats on hottish days. I do recommend that in somewhat way, despite cosplayers wearing hats or whatever, you know what I mean, who go to whatever cons, despite, you know, odours and whatnot. Then it is because of just lately though, this past year, I noticed, because I'm trying to look after my eyes as it is, even though I'm really in front of a desk lamp, and despite last year my optician said I'm good enough for you know, to see stuff, I got good eyes still, but if I wanted to go to a work environment, but despite not being workable, you know, I'd have to wear glasses. But since I'm alright, even I'm using whatever like orange filters on my phone, you know, and all that jazz. But when it's like sunny, I tend to use my hat, because, you know, I'm very sensitive to light because my autism and whatnot. I usually tend to use this as like a good, because like, say for example, when I'm in the car with my mum, you know, you have like your sun thingy, you know, your flip up sun thing when you want to block the sun when you're driving and all that. And, knowing the sun, you know, you're in the car moving and the sun is always in different angles, so I tend to use this as like a, you know, like boop, 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 you know, quickly, because I'm trying to look after my eyes a bit better since I only just recently been to the opticians last year, and you know, trying to look after my eyes a bit better because, you know, the whole like blue light controversy with phones, devices, etc. And trying to look after my eyes a bit better. Even though I'm constantly looking at the blooming or was it desk lamp to use weather lighting for my vlogs, but you know. And despite that, you know, I've just been enjoying, you know, wearing a military cap. It's just like my symbol, like Batman has a symbol, I have a symbol, you know, regarding, you know, who I am. And I just like that to go along with my geeky shirts, along the numerous amount of t-shirts as I have, because, you know, I tend to change my styles, but I'm quite happy with the style that I might just stick with for quite some years until I'm like 40 or 50 for that matter. But it's just something that I just like having my own style. Then it's not just the t-shirts, but you know, I've been through different types of watches because, you know, I got a new Pebble watch recently. But you know, this sort of style that I tend to grown into for quite some years, despite, you know, before the military cap, I wore one of the t-shirts and now I'm just wearing one of the t-shirts. and despite accumulating t-shirts, which I'm trying not to do, is another thing. Anyways, what I've been up to this past 1 week, I've been feeling quite a bit meh since the start of the week, even though I mentioned on my last vlog, the last following weekend, as I've been feeling a bit meh, even though just last week, like I said, my services have been cancelled the following week, so I haven't been to see my services lately, and I just literally, since the start of the week, despite, I just felt like bursting into tears because of, I just felt all emotional and all that, lately, because I haven't been to see my services, because usually lately, for the past few months now, the services is just a good relief because I've been literally not been in TOs, and the only time I've been into TOs is when I go to my services now, which is good because I guess the medication is really affecting since the start of the year that is doing this and that to preoccupy, that is seeing my friend quite regularly, you know, so it's been good. And despite, I think it's because my mum noticed that, and despite, you know, knowing my blooming routines in my head in general, and it makes sense why I had to burst into tears because, you know, I haven't been seeing my services. I was eager because of, this was, you know, when I've been to MCM, I was due to see my services. I was tempted to see my services to mention about, oh, how's MCM? Oh, it's been great, you know? And despite this and that, you know, I mentioned my MCM vlog, so even talking about it. So I was due for, you know, seeing my services, and I just literally burst into tears despite feeling meh since the start of the week. But I'm hopefully, fingers crossed, I'll be seeing my services next week and, you know, have a good old chat and chat about this and that despite having catch up, despite the whole MCM thing, which I need to mention to my services about that. So, you know, I'm just going through this and that at the moment. Then it's doing my, you know, Fortnite thing because of, you know, even though I do see my service every fortnight, I do my thing every fortnight, and that is, you know, go to my charity shops and cash converters, and I didn't see that much, to be honest, which is good, though, because I'm trying to, like, currently save up because, you know, there's quite a number of games come out at the end of this year for next week and the week after, so I've been literally been saving up my week allowance since then, despite buying whatever throughout the week, I should say, because it's literally going to be my birthday next week, because I'm really looking forward to that, which I mentioned about in a bit. Maybe at the end of the vlog. Then it is, because, so I'm just going from my notes. Despite streaming as it is, because I mentioned at the start of the vlog, you know, with the whole streaming controversy, even though I'm a streamer myself. And it's funny because I mentioned my last vlog that I was going to stream Jackbox Pi because I've been watching a certain streamer, you know, and I interacted playing whether Jackbox Pi games, and I thought I'd stream a Jackbox Pi. Game of words mixed up today. A Jackbox Party, you know, this week, since one of the Jackbox games were added to the Xbox Game Pass this past week. And I thought I'd stream it. Even though for those people that watch it on demand or for those people that tuned in, I do appreciate you. Thank you for tuning in. But I was just literally like a, eh, you know, because like I said last week, I'd just been feeling a bit meh. I'm feeling like a people meh. So I was like, not myself, I should say. And even though that was like, eh, people. Oh, no one's not playing with me. No one's playing with me. You know, that sort of thing. But the stream ended on the high note. And here's a minor clip. Despite him, it was nice that Crude Lord and one of my closest friends end up joining, and despite this and that, and to end the stream on a high note, I should say. I didn't realise there was like a money count thing on the top, despite I was like, bid, and it was buying video games as I do. And the winner is Crude Lord, yay! Well done. Oh, the loan thing, yes. So the winner is that. Oh! should not have done them loans. Okay, Lord. Well, then it is watching certain streamers as another thing, because lately I've been watching weather streamers, even though most streamers can't stream all the time, you know, despite, you know, constantly uploading on YouTube. But anywho, despite I'm mostly YouTube as it is, but I'm trying to stream, you know, once a week as it is. There's certain streamers who I do actually watch, who I follow, just streams now and again, but lately though, the certain people I follow have been busy, like moving or doing this and that. I'm referring to certain streamers, even though the good old Octavius just just streamed whenever she feels like. Because she recently had her birthday, and happy birthday to you, and even though it was only just this past week, she had her birthday, because we're kind of both 31 for this year, for that matter. Because it was quite ironic, because of, you know, it's been like a year since not only watching Octavius, but, you know, watching certain streamers since the end of last year, because, you know, I was not feeling myself, but I'm feeling a bit more better, despite, you know, most streamers are doing whatever, you know, throughout this year, and, you know, the on and off streams. But I've been watching one of the streamers, I should say, long story short. And despite when Octavius did recently streamed, and despite, you know, it was recently her birthday, and I thought I'll try and tune in as soon as I can. And I had whether only had like 30 odd bits, and I gave her that, even though I only just recently topped up, you know, I know the method on how to top up my bits, I only just topped up my bits despite buying well with my week allowance. Anywho, but yeah, lately though, despite not just Octavius, just most streamers that I've been watching have just not been interactive as much. While I do watch certain streamers who have a really small view count, and I do really interact, because, you know, I have them on and off days. It was quite funny. Because last year, it's the same, ever get that feeling of deja vu? Because Adrian went to Spain, and he did so the game again this year, if that makes sense, because he did it twice. Because when it was last year, when I first interacted with Octavius, and Adrian went to Spain, and ever get that feeling of deja vu, it happened again. But I tried to interact with one of the streamers and did whatever most nights, I should say. So I only just like literally just chatted to him just recently, you know, and just mentioned whatever in this vlog, despite chatting to whoever they've seen, whoever, because of you know, I've been to see my friend who I've seen quite regularly this past week, those doing whatever and chatting to various people, not just streamers, but, you know, various people, which I try not to talk about, because, you know, I try to not talk about this and that, despite mentioning people. But with that then, and despite chatting to people and whoever, I'm just looking forward to my birthday all round, because it's going to be quite a busy week for me next week, because of not only that it's my birthday, Fridays and Saturdays mixed up, even though I might not plan to do a normal vlog for next week for that matter, because I might do a special, you know, birthday vlog, depends on how my birthday goes, which I'll still plan to do. I'll mention whatever on my birthday vlog, since I might be editing it on my phone, hopefully, fingers crossed, it will work. Then it is because I heard like Rad is coming out next week, and hopefully, fingers crossed, because of Gamescom is happening next week, and I've been hearing some rumours that Microsoft with Xbox Game Pass and whatnot, they might announce some newer games, and hopefully, fingers crossed, that Rad, and because Rad is a certain game that will be released next week that is made by the developers of Double Find, and, you know, since the E3 announcement this year, that Microsoft kind of owns Double Find, so hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll get to see, like, Rad, Rigs, you know, added to Xbox Game Pass. That'll be a good announcement for Gamescom for next week. But it'll be sad, though, because of it's on a Monday, despite both not only seeing my services on that following Monday, but I got a dentist appointment. It's mainly a checkup, because, you know, quite some months ago I had the filling reinstalled, I should say. And it's a checkup that I'm had to do next week. So I will have to miss out the Inside Xbox show, which will be quite sad, really, so I'm going to miss out on certain announcements, but I might turn my Xbox on and leave it on, because I don't want to miss out the mix pot when it comes to the mixer, which I only use mixer for the mix pot stuff when it comes to Xbox related stuff. But despite that, I'm looking forward to streaming this week, despite I might, hopefully, fingers crossed, if I do plan to get a certain arcade cabinet for my birthday, I might stream that for the next following week. Ooh. But other than that, though, I have quite a busy week for next week, despite doing web videos, because, like I said, since the past few weeks, it's been quite a few dryish weeks, even though there's been some stuff that came out, because, you know, just this past week, the Apex Legends solo thing that happened, and I did a video of that, even though on the same day, but so I thought I'd quickly mention, despite what I'm streaming for this week. And this is this game that I just played this morning, despite last night, called, I think it's called Slay the Spire. I just literally played it, which is basically, get this right, a turn-based RPG somewhat. It's similar to like, if you ever played, what's it called, Hand of Fate, and it's like a, so, something like that, and it's got like an Arkham gameplay for that, but it's totally different to Hand of Fate. And Slay of Spear is basically like a turn-based RPG, and you use your cards and to attack and whatnot, which I think is a cool concept. What's better yet, it's randomly generated, so every time you do a new thing, it randomly generates, but the final boss was quite hard. But I'm planning to stream that this week, since it's only just recently added to Xbox Game Pass that I just tried out just now. So I just thought about that despite streaming weather for this week. Anyways, we'll leave that now before I go into a tangent and we'll leave it that now. I'm trying to cram whatever I do despite going to a tangent. Anyway, so that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying this vlog, watching and understanding, and hope you guys have a nice weekend, nonetheless. Do not forget to pump on my social media of what I'm up to. Anyways, I'll let you guys get on with your day. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.